it's Jang here from the unofficial LEGO Hero Factory MOCs blog and Bionicle Untold. This right here is obviously Takanuva, the original Toa of Light. It's a classic figure, classic set, and it's small. But you know it's not small? That guy! That is my Takanuva Mega Titan MOC, built in 2009. It measures a little over 22 inches in height when standing normally, which makes it the second tallest standing MOC that I've made. Inspiration for the whole thing just started with the chest plate from the Takanuva Titan set. I looked at it and thought I saw a face there and decided, you know what, I'm gonna make a head from this and build everything else down from there. I basically just tried to follow the lines, these sort of telltale trademark lines of kind of swooping rearward facing strakes that have been common to the Takanuva masks since the beginning. It's kind of his look. And also down below by the mouth, there are these constructs that are kind of like a breathing apparatus or input for air to come in. And to build those here, I used the pieces from the arms or for the rotating weapons for the Toa Mari Pohatu kit. Now out of this whole set, the thing that I like the most is, well, it's not a set, but the whole creation, would be the arms. I always try to make my creations in such a way that they'll have plenty of articulation so they can really be posed, they're really usable. So of course I've got just basic elbow movement and flexible wrist. The elbow movement comes from just a ratcheted joint from the old Makuta pterodactyls. Right here in the fingers and in the wrist, you just have regular ball joints. That's all pretty simple. For the shoulder can rotate in and out like this, which is useful for getting poses where the arm goes across the body or across the face. And that just comes from two ball joints that are one right above the other. Then, of course, you can move the entire arm up and down at the shoulder joint. Pretty important form of articulation there. And another thing that was important to me when I was making this creation was the ability to take it apart. I built it at home, but I needed to display it somewhere else. So the entire arm is attached just by one little axle stub, just like that. The whole arm comes right off. You can take off both arms. The legs will also come off, which just makes it a lot easier to transport. Now, how does that entire arm get held up by just one axle stub and not just flop around? The secret is this gearbox. Each individual gear that you see here has an axle pin with friction in it attached to it. That's the friction of six of those blue axle pin pieces that have the friction strakes on the sides of them. And that's enough to hold up the entire arm. Even when I stretch it out all the way, you can see it still holds itself up. You try to go completely straight, it settles for a second, but then it comes to a stop. One other bit of articulation you get from the shoulder joint is this way, out and in. And again, it just helps to add a little bit more angular movement to get some other different poses out of it. So here you can see it's not a whole lot, but on one side you see that arm is in, on the other side is all the way out. Hey, look, he can touch his forehead. Now the body is kind of comical. It's really disproportionate. It really went extreme with the superhero figure, kind of really big chest and a tiny little waist. And normally that would pose a problem with weight, except that this figure is actually hollow on the inside, which allows a relatively small joint to hold the thing up. When I turn it around here, you can see that it's fairly skeletal, almost like a rib cage around the backside. It just kind of gives the feel of the size, and it gives it a three-dimensionality without actually filling everything up and ending up with a 10-pound model. As a result, because it's so lightweight, there's only two little joints on each side. You've got one of these Makuta ratcheted joints and then just a regular ball joint in the front. Having a set like that on each side allows the whole character to lean over and it can stand on one foot. Now for the thighs, I just used axles that go through pin to axle right angle adapters, and that's right there. Those two points are where the friction comes for that. That's for the thighs. The center point, center section is solid on these legs, and then down from the bottom, each lower leg has two full leg pieces in there, plus one hydraulic ram. And that's all that's used to give all of the motion for the knee, as well as for the foot. For a big mock, he can do some interesting poses. The head, of course, is articulated as well. Does not actually look up very much, kind of looks just a little bit above level, but he can certainly turn his head to the left and to the right. He's got a number of joints that kind of work together for that. And most importantly, because he is so tall, he can look way down at the puny little tiny mocks that surround him. The final detail is the power lance. Now, the inspiration for this just came directly out of the paintings and the comic pictures in the fiction works that were done. In those pictures, I saw that the power lance for Takanuva, once he came into his larger form, his power lance was just enormous. And I tried to duplicate that here, where you can see that the weapon, even as it is, just looks absolutely ridiculously huge in size. But if you look at the comic renderings, it's fairly close in proportions, where the blades are just huge. Got the serrated insides. This is really a fairly simple piece, nothing really special going on with it. So there you have it. That's my Bionicle Takanuva Mega Titan creation. It's just about between 22 and 23 inches tall. He's got his oversized power lance with him. Not a great mock overall, not by any means. Just something that I had a lot of fun doing, basically just starting from one single part as the inspiration to do the entire creation and just building it up from there. It was fun to make, and I really enjoy putting together things that can be posed in many ways. Hope you enjoyed seeing this, and I hope to see you again. Please be sure to subscribe to my channel. It's Lego Jang on YouTube, and also check out my Bionicle and Hero Factory blogs. Talk to you again soon.